In this video, I'll show you how you can edit the stitches of your embroidery designs, and that is done with the Edit Stitches tool here on the left-hand toolbar. And so to demonstrate this, we'll just travel to our browser, select one of the CMX artworks, double-click to click to create the embroidery design. I'm going to zoom in over top of part of our design, and then this is the tool here, Edit Stitches. And before you can use the Edit Stitches tool, we're going to need to turn off the Auto Sequence Control. You see, right now, while Auto Sequence Control is turned on, if I select a shape, although it will select the shape, it does not allow me to select the individual stitches and move them. Now, when I turn off the Automatic Sequence Control, now I can see the shape again if I select the shape. Notice now all of the stitch points have been highlighted with a bright, I guess, purple dot. And now I can click on those stitch points and actually move them, you know, to be kind of any place that I want. And so in this way, you can make very specific edits to the designs to control precisely how the stitching is going to sew. Not only can you select one stitch point at a time, if you click and drag a selection box, you can select multiple stitches and then click and drag to move those multiple stitches. You can also use delete on your keyboard to delete stitches. We can right click to insert new stitches. Left or right click again to complete adding new stitches. And so this is the way that we're able to edit stitches in our designs to make very specific changes. Now, when we're completed making our stitch edits, if you decide at a later time that you no longer want them, you can select the shape. And while in selection mode, if you right click over top, there is an option to clear the stitch editing. And so now you would go right back to the beginning again. If I select the shape, choose Edit Stitches, and come in and make some specific, you know, changes to the shape. And then if at any time we try and resize this object, so by using the selection tool and resizing it, notice the little warning that comes up here. Stitch edited objects could not regenerate stitches. Okay, we can clear the error right here. But what that said to me was, you made your shape bigger, but we're not able to adjust the stitching and create new stitching because it's been temporarily locked based on the fact that I had done those stitch edits. And if I no longer wish for that to, if I want to, it to allow it to regenerate the stitches, well, of course, you know, you can right click and tell it to clear the editing. But also, I'm going to undo, and I'm going to turn back on the auto sequence, auto sequence control, and go control A. Even if I try and select my entire design and resize the entire design, I do get the error generated. Stitch edited objects could not regenerate items. And if I click on the error, it will actually ask me, do you want to erase the stitch editing and recalculate? And if you say okay, then it allows the software to release those manually edited stitches and then generate new, you know, stitching for the shape. And then, and in that way, then the stitch edits have been lost. So to kind of finalize, turn off auto sequence control, turn on edit stitches, select the shape, select the needle, the points. You can select multiple points. So if you want to move a whole section of an area, you know, over, there are many times where you may want to be able to edit the stitches. And so this is how it is done using the Edit Stitch tool.